Hi everyone. Sorry, I know there's a lot of sort of messy background distraction going on there, but I literally got home just now from the Sunday class. Obviously, hi everyone, thanks for joining me on Penumbradol Beauty. So hopefully that footage came out of my newsreader look. So that's at the beginning of the video. But anyway, it was fun yesterday, the class. And we did get the kit, so I will show that. But what I might do is just do a separate link, because I just want to talk a little bit about some stuff in this one, obviously, because it is the vlog. And then I'll just do a view of the kit. And I've got a home kit, and I've got a sort of a class makeup kit as well. So I'll do that, so I can really spend a little bit more time on there. Anyway, if you stay to listen to my rambling, I just want to say it's good too. We've actually gotten the little manuals. Apparently it's been 2 years in the making. I think maybe the classes have been running for 2 years. I'm not 100% sure. But we finally got a manual, which I think will be the one given for all Certificate 2 students. But it's good because I've always been wanting to at least read ahead, like I assume most classes can, just a little bit. So that's good. I can actually do that now. And as far as yesterday, we did the liquid liner, the gel liner with the wing, and that was just, if I'm 100% honest, the worst thing that I find, or the most frustrating thing I find, is doing sort of eye looks, and particularly gel eyeliner. It's something I just don't do too often, because I'm not confident doing it, and particularly I feel like I get shaky hands when I go to do the gel liner. So for me, I normally just do very nude, basic eye looks, and I also use liquid liner or like felt tip liquid liner, and I steer away from pencils and I steer away from gel eyeliner. Now, because during this course it's actually been obviously good on multiple levels, obviously that, you know, I want to get this certification, I want to do makeup on people, I love it, but it's also getting me out of my little rut. Like I'm thinking, oh no, this is all that I do, this is all that I can do, this is all that. So it, as much as it is, you get that, you know, you really have to face head on things that you know you are not good at, you know you need lots of practice in it. And that's one area, is particularly gel eyeliner, sort of knowing the pressure to use to get a light thin line, or to get, you know, a bold line, and how to get that nice wispy wing, and sort of how to judge what angle actually suits someone's eye and the whole sort of look. So that, you know, it's really good for getting me out of that little rut. And it's also been good where I also, because we're interacting with each other, we're practicing on each other, the students in the class, is that as much as some people seem confident and they're really good at certain things, it's kind of good to hear too when they are just as worried as I am. Like I'm like, oh, you know, trying to get the perfect wing, and then I ended up doing about 3 times, like a lot of it. But then when you look around, you see other people that are way ahead of you, and you're like, oh, and then you look around and someone else is struggling on the same area that you are, and you're like, oh, it's okay, we're all human, we're all here to learn, we've paid the money to learn, just relax, just enjoy it, you know. I should be making mistakes, so that way I can sort of learn, and there's not one right way to do everything. Like, we'll learn from the trainer, we have a different trainer, they do something slightly different. I watch someone else do it, and I'm going, oh, that's actually, I like that way better. And then you practice and go, actually, no, I like this. It's a lot of different, sort of different things combined, so I really do like that. As much as I get like, oh, I've got the adrenaline going and oh my gosh, and I get also worried in there, at the same time it's a lot of fun, and we just laugh, like we laugh because it's just, oh gosh, you know, it's like whoosh, and like whoa, you know, you didn't blend the gel eyeliner or the eyeshadow or something, and you look like you're out of the Rocky Horror Picture Show or something. I don't know, it's just okay, that's not the look we're going for, but you know, it is really fun. And even things like, for the actual kit in the class, we get 16 brushes, like your basic brushes for face and eye. And obviously I've tried lots of different brushes over the years, and they also recommend different types of brushes that you can use. But when I look at my brushes, I've got lots of Royal Lanica ones that I've never opened. You know, I've gotten from IMAT shows, I've gotten other types, even with the Real Techniques, a lot that I love, but there's some of the brushes I just don't use. Like I've maybe used once or twice, and I've depth cleansed them and put them away, and it's just, that's it. They're just good to look at. So because of this, I've been breaking out a lot more of my brushes, and even some of the new ones, I've just, you know, deep cleansed them, still have to clean them anyway, and then I've incorporated them into the roll. So I've now quite a large sort of selection of brushes to sort of play with, but it's good because I'm trying to see which ones I like best. So it's kind of good for me in the class as well, and when I'm practicing, or whether it be on my husband or whoever will let me near them, so what I like better. So that has been really good as well. And also in my personal things, I don't want to mix the brushes. I've been using brushes I've never actually really liked. For example, this is a Royal Laniker one, and it's called the Super Foundation C142. Now I know it's a dupe for another large foundation brush out there. I'm not sure what it was because I was never really interested in it, to be completely honest, but I did buy it because of the hype. I put it at IMAT, so it was a great price though. And I thought, oh yeah, yeah, and other people were just blown away by the brush, and I tried it, and I thought, yeah. Went back to my stippling brushes, all my flat top kabuki brushes, which are what I predominantly use personally for liquid foundation. And then just over the last week, I thought, that brush, that's such a sad looking brush. It's just sitting there. I like the look of it, and I'm thinking, I've got to try. I've been using the flat, or the flat foundation brushes as well. So I'm thinking in class, I'm thinking, No, I've got to try it again. And what do you know? I really like it. I actually really, really like it. And I'm thinking, oh. So it is good. It's sort of breaking me out of my my own little rut too. Because I mean, as far as, like, a lot of us love makeup, love playing with makeup and tools and accessories. We also get into little things where we're like, oh, actually I like this, and it's quicker to do it this way, and oh, actually I like these, and blah blah blah. And every now and then I'll get something else out. But it has really gotten me out trying different things, and then practicing using pencils at home. Like, I don't have liquid eyeliner on today. I've got like pencil, and it's probably smeared all over the place. It doesn't matter. I'm just looking after my son today and catching up on chores and, you know, doing a post, so it doesn't matter. But I'm just trying different things that I would otherwise not normally. So for me, it's a great thing, and it's good because I've got a lot of stuff, as I'm sure you've seen, I need to use it. So stuff like this and using other different colours and that, it's been fun. I've even practiced depotting. Like, I've got a lot of new lipsticks that I've never used, that are just sitting there going, oh, and I've been practicing depotting them and putting them in palettes, and it's been fun. I've made an absolute mess. I was going to take a photo of it once, but it was just like, I don't know how I did it, but I just managed to get lipstick underneath the palette, and then I didn't know it was on my hand. It ended up on the desk, and it ended up on my pants, and it ended up everywhere around the house and on the door, and I'm like, but yeah, another thing I must say is consumables. Now, obviously, we spend money, you know, building up a kit and eyeshadows or whatever, or we use your basic stuff. But consumables, you might go through a lot. I'm talking about things like tissues, your cleanser, like your skincare or your skin prep, and tissues and applicators or disposables and Q-tips and that. But I've been finding, because I get so sort of nervous, I'll use a Q-tip and then use another thing, or I'll have my foundation out and then I'll wipe it off with a tissue, and then I'll do this and I'll knock some, I'll wipe this, and I use a big tissue and wipe that down, and I do another one, and I need to use a spatula, and I use another tissue, and I'm thinking, I'm slowly getting into a system where I'm thinking, actually no, if I work like that, like clean someone's face and use like five buds at a time, pads, cotton pads, and like 50 cotton tips and all that, I'm going to be just throwing money away. You know, I need to sort of streamline what I'm doing. So if I wipe, clean the spatula, spray it and clean it, I can use that little bit of there, fold it over, use the other end. If I'm cleansing someone's face, I've got one side there, turn it over, more of a product, cleanse it there. So I've got to get into a proper system of sort of doing things, so I'm not wasting as much product as well. So it's not just you look professional as you're sort of doing everything in a sort of system and you're keeping everything neat and clean. It's also you're saving money, because otherwise I'm literally going to be not only looking like a messy git, I'm also going to be throwing money away, and I'm just going to be so unorganized. I'll look unorganized. So I can have the best makeup in the world and the best looking brushes, but when everything's everywhere and all that, it's just not going to look professional. I'm going to get even more flustered. So it's getting that system down of doing everything, you know, sort of in a different way. Because when you watch different trend makeup artists, they have a certain way of doing things. It all seems very elegant and very, but it's very practiced. That's the whole thing. It's very streamlined and very practiced. That way they sort of, you know, but it's also being ergonomic. You're not bending down doing this and up here and over there with that kit and doing this and fluffing around. And you've got certain time limits as well. Like in class, sometimes we're like, you know, we've got 10 for 5 minutes or something to do a particular look, because we've got to swap over and let the other person have that same amount of time that we did. So we are rushing. So if I'm trying to find Q-tips and I've got rubbish here and then I've got to get another rubbish bag out and all that, I'm wasting time. So we've got to be streamlined, we've got to have a system, we've got to look professional, be neat. Money-wise as well, I can't be wasting so much stuff, like digging in with the spatula and getting out way much more concealer than I need. I've got to, you know, contain everything. So you've got to contain everything. And that way, and you also look professional. And then sometimes you actually feel more confident when you actually have your system down and you've got everything out, and you know, you actually start to feel more confident, which is kind of weird. But it's and you look at, and then whether whoever's you're working on might feel much more confident on what you're doing to them just by mere presentation, and then obviously your skill, like how you're actually doing the makeup and that. But it's really interesting. It's almost like a whole act of how you're doing the whole system and how you're doing their makeup. Obviously you got to know what you're doing, you know. It's no good having all the other stuff and then just like you're no good at makeup. But it's a whole thing, and I didn't really honestly appreciate it before. And I think it's also what makes some really good artists, and what some really, really like, oh, you know, okay artists, is that you've got to have all of that. You've got to have all of that on, like happening really, really well. And also, you know, explaining to the person, keeping them relaxed, being relaxed. But, you know, it's really interesting. I never really thought about it. I mean, when I went slowly watching people sort of doing the makeup, and just even, you know, the way they, you know, grab a brush and do the thing like this, it's a whole sort of flow of thing. And then as they're doing that, you're watching them, you feel more confident in what they're doing. It's really weird. It's like a, I don't know, I'm surely someone out there understands that I'm talking about it, but it's a two-way sort of thing, from whether it's the client or us, that we're, you know, we're learning from this particular person. Yeah. I don't know, hopefully that makes sense. And that's sort of why I wanted to sort of have my kit separately, because I'm just rambling. So, but that's sort of what I wanted to share with you, and that's sort of how I'm finding the class and that. So yes, I think in a couple of weeks we'll be doing the mature age makeup. I'm not 100% sure what we'll be doing next week, but it's just fun being able to look ahead. We've got color corrective, concealing, there's all these different. We haven't actually done face charts yet, which I thought we would have done by now. I thought we were supposed to do yes. Someone mentioned we were going to do it yesterday, but we didn't. So I'm looking forward to doing that. It's not like I can't look it up online or also already know how to do it, but it's good when you actually do it with another makeup artist or a couple of makeup artists and stuff like that. So yeah, that'll be interesting. Anyway, I will link the kit down below. So thanks for listening to my makeup rambling adventures.